Hi, I'm John Leitenberg. I'm the executive director for Love Inc. And last week was Administrative Professionals Day, and hopefully your church did something nice to say thank you. But we wanted to do something nice to say thank you too. And so just sending you this quick video to say thank you for the work you do. You are, as a church secretary, on the front line of your church. You know all that's going on, and you're just an important person, and we thank you for how you represent Christ to the community through your role. One of the things that probably happens to you as a church secretary is from time to time you get a call or someone drops by looking for help, and we wanted you to know that Love Inc. is a resource there to help you, help your church with that encounter. Probably the main way we can help you is through our clearinghouse. And so Kane here is our clearinghouse coordinator, and I thought he could just share a little bit about what he does and how he can help you in your role.
Yeah, hi, my name's Kane, and the clearinghouse is a kind of a hub where you can take and funnel all those encounters that John was just talking about into one place, and then we've got trained church volunteers that are partners with the other churches in our community that are prepared to discuss resources with these people when they call in, and additionally to just listen to them and let it be a relational experience. One of the other things that's really important is we're able to help avoid the overlap that takes place a lot with church shopping, where you have people that are looking for resources and they're not really looking for assistance so much as just what can they get, and they're going to go down the list. So we can kind of find a way to eliminate some of that. I think another really important component is that where we can see people that are having a trend of asking for help year after year, because we keep track of everything. So we can really validate where this need is creating an impact in their life and actually moving them into a place of healing.
One of the things that Kane does a great job with, and that he has helped the volunteers that answer the phone do a great job with, is so often the need comes in and we think the call is about the need, but really it's about the person. Just the other day we had a guy stop by the office. I happened to be sitting outside, and he said he was looking for gas money to get to Cody, Wyoming. And that's where my mind went. I was like, well, have you talked? I started going through the resources in the community of where he could get help. And then Kane walked up as we were sitting there, and he started talking to him, not about his need, but using that need as an open door to talk about him and where is he going and why is he in Rapid City, and as he considered various options and just what his needs are. And that's really key there. So
that's a really good point, because inherently we are, and we're established in the clearinghouse to be ministers. And a lot of times when someone comes to the church, the pastor's working on his message, he's got a lot going on, he's kind of getting blindsided with some of these requests. So this is a resource where you can send somebody to a place where they're not going to just be dismissed. As John was saying, that man actually ended up in my office sitting down, and he got to pray for the first time. He didn't know how to pray, but I told him there was no wrong way to pray, and he ended up praying, and it changed him. You can see it change him. So he left with maybe not gas money, but he had hope and direction, and he had a belief that he was valued. And all of our church volunteers who, we have two out there right now that are working, that they're trained how to do that, how to really look at somebody. And we're training through Christ. We're training through the relationship that we have with Jesus, so we know it's effective because then the Holy Spirit gets involved.
So one of the things you need to know, if you do say, well, our church partners with Love Inc., or are you aware of Love Inc., you can call them. The Clearinghouse and Love Inc., we're not a crisis center. We're not emergency response. We also don't provide direct financial help. And often it's financial help that is what people are looking for, because that is the tip, the greatest symptom of the problems they're facing in life. Hopefully when they call, we'll have time to unwind that a little bit and find out what deeper things are going on. But it isn't just passing the buck. There are direct ministries that the Clearinghouse does and that Love Inc. does and that we can resource them into. Do you want to touch on that?
Sure. So, you know, the reality that comes to mind is that, you know, the woman, she came to the well to meet Jesus. She didn't come there to meet Jesus. She actually came there for water. And that's what happens here all the time. People are coming here for needs. So we don't dismiss that. We acknowledge that that's not our goal, but we then come back to it. Some of those resources that we are blessed by you, the church, to be able to offer the community is kitchen supplies to get established to be able to cook some food, bedding so they can have some blankets, some pillows, some mats on the floor, and then even further, we can help establish the entirety of a home with furniture that has been donated by the community. So, and that's those are a few of the areas where we try to create conduits or open doors to have relationships. And by the time someone actually receives furniture, generally they've already had a chance to just communicate with three different church volunteers, and oftentimes have got to be incorporate some prayer into that and to let the spiritual side of it start to soften. So
we had three people that worked for furniture last week through volunteering, and all three of them were seeking connections with the church. None of them went to church, but through this process, they are going to start connecting with church, and it was just really meaningful. We also have a home repair team for elderly and disabled people and appliances that will help people with. So obviously there's lots of volunteer needs there, but we really wanted you to be aware of the resources we have. We also have great working relationships with a lot of the agencies in town, so you don't have to know all the resources. Our volunteers in Kane, they're aware of that. Another thing you can do, if your church is working with someone, maybe you decide, you know what, we are going to help, or we'd like to help, but let's call Love Inc., let's talk to Kane, and see if they've called Love Inc. before, see if there's a history here with this person. We would love to connect with you and partner with you in that way. And even in some church benevolence things, sometimes a church is helping people and they're like, oh, you know, we've helped them one, two times, but we're not seeing change. Well, that might be a great opportunity to connect them into our Life Inc. program and say, you know, for us to keep helping you, we want to see you move forward. Maybe you should take a financial class through our Love Inc.'s Life Inc. classes. So lots of ways to connect, but overall, we just wanted you to know we're here for you. Maybe you can't remember all this, but you can remember this handsome face. Just call Love Inc. and say, hey, what can I do in this situation? Or can you help with this? Or just have them call us. It's 718-LOVE. It's easy to remember.
A good point that John just touched on is this idea of all the resources in the community. I know when I started working here, I was just lost. It's so many different things and they're constantly changing. So we're working full time to be effective at pointing people into the different agencies with love so that it's not just sterile, so they're getting the spiritual connection that they need. But also back to the churches. So we're calling you and we're talking to you and seeing how you're interacting with the community. So this is a resource for you. That's our goal, is to help you do your job better so that as you are connecting with these divine appointments that God's placed on your church doorstep or on your phone line, that we can, you know, get them pointed into something that's going to change their life in a good way. And those classes that John's talking about, they're awesome. They're a great representation of community that we want to see happen. One other point that came up is people participate. You know, they're not going to just receive stuff. There is a process. So if you're looking to see if someone's just kind of taken and taken and not really transforming or growing or even getting pointed out of the direction that they're in that's causing a harm in their life, we have multiple ways that we get people engaged so that they are a part of this change. It's not us fixing people. It's us working with people together so we can all grow together. It's a beautiful process.
So finally, just as a way to say thank you, we are partnering with Harriet and Oak, a new coffee store downtown in the old TMA building. So we'd like to offer you a free drink on Love Inc. And to head down there, give them your name and your church, and they'll give you a drink. on us. So thanks for your work. I hope you have a great year. God bless.